Good day, everyone. Welcome to the GitLab 16.3 planning. This is the planning for GitLab 16.3 release in August of 2023. And I'd like to go over a few of the features that the GitLab team is prepared to work on and or deliver in this time frame. We have a lot of PTO scheduled at the end of summer here as we approach the August dates. Therefore, we're expecting slightly lower than normal capacity for the 16.3 milestone. So I just want to point that out before we get started. I'm going to highlight a few things here that we're very interested in delivering that I think will have a large customer impact. I may not highlight everything in order to keep the timing of this reasonable so that people will be able to see this in a brief amount of time. The first thing, one of our key objectives here is server-side backups. I'll go ahead and click over to that. Right now, we have a blueprint online, which I link in the planning document right here. And the blueprint is sort of our engineering planning, engineering design paperwork that we do in a way that allows us to get broader audience participation and review of sort of architectural or more major changes. Server-side backups have been a bit of a concern for our users, rightfully so, and we are addressing those in this way. As you can see, we have server-side incremental backups, which is being worked. These are all sub-epics and sub-issues. And we have almost completed the MVC for this. So we're quite excited about that. We want to continue working on these. We think that these are going to bring tremendous value to our self-managed customers. And therefore, we're trying to finish off that MVP. The second thing I want to highlight is the implementation of write-ahead logging in GitLab. This is actually a whole separate topic that is sort of a sub-piece of implementing a Raft-based decentralized architecture for our Prefect transition over to Raft. That's about a year out, we're thinking, maybe a little less. But the write-ahead logging is actually utilized in a lot of ways, and we're hoping to be able to leverage this for disaster recovery operations, potentially backup operations, and some other operations at GitLab and for our customers. So this is quite exciting for our team. We are in the process of implementing this. There's a lot of work to be done here, and we're trying to pick off a few issues every release and make the best progress we can toward implementing this in a timely manner. Finally, under engineering priorities, we are investigating opportunities around the Git bundle URI. This is pretty exciting. This is a new feature for Git upstream itself. These bundle URIs are locations where Git can download one or more bundles in order to sort of bootstrap an object database. What this means to the users is bundles could be stored in multiple locations, and when an initial clone takes place, those bundles can be pulled in place of having to query the server for that data. This gives us a lot of flexibility, actually, because there are opportunities here where we could actually reduce load from CI pipelines. We could actually geo-distribute bundles. There's a lot of opportunity here where we could put those bundles on like an object storage device potentially, and this would allow clients access to those, and it would be routed to the closest server to them through like a geolocation system. So that's a pretty exciting opportunity. For this release, we're not necessarily planning on implementing anything, but we are trying to explore what this could allow us and sort of then prioritize based on what this investigation shows. We'll prioritize features coming out of this. So that's a pretty interesting opportunity for us. And additionally, I wanted to sort of talk about a couple of the technical debt things we're looking to eliminate this release. We want to remove the in-memory implementation of some of the replication jobs queue. This is something that's been ongoing, and it's something we're sort of trying to finalize. And we are really right now in a position where we can finalize this, which is pretty exciting. It's been a long time coming, and that will eliminate the in-memory implementation for this replication jobs. And that opens up doors for us going forward for other things. So that's really exciting. The final thing is the Git attributes. We now have an opportunity to read these directly off of the repository itself. So there's really no reason for us to read them out and store them in a separate file anymore or extract them. This does make our repository storage a lot simpler, and it allows us to move storages around in an easier way without having to worry so much about the app or the attributes file. So this again is one of those sort of baseline functionalities that we're excited to bring to the product in a way to reduce complexity and improve our cross-functional approach to things. So this is really interesting for us. As always, if there are any questions, please feel free to either leave a comment on this video or go ahead and leave comments on the issues themselves or this planning issue. We welcome all participation. I look forward to discussing this with anybody who's interested. If you ever want to reach out to me or my team, please feel free to do so. We'd be happy to talk to you about opportunities or improvements that you see in our product that we'd like to, you know, hear about and understand better. Thank you so much and have a great day.